Bonjour à tous et à toutes.
Hello everyone and welcome to this science and technology segment. I'm Serge Kofi.
Panthéon préhistorique.
A 3.8 million year old remarkably complete Australopithecus skull was discovered in Ethiopia. That was last week. It is a discovery that once again challenges our vision on evolution. According to researchers, this skull is one of the most complete hominid fossils, more than 3 million years old, an asset that could make it become a new icon of human evolution. This discovery thus joins the famous Tomai, Ardi, and Lucy. By way of comparison, Tomai is considered by some paleontologists to be the first representative of the human lineage. It is about 7 million years old. It was discovered in Chad in 2001. Ardi, which was discovered in Ethiopia, would be 4.5 million years old. And Lucy, the very famous Australopithecus discovered in Ethiopia in 1974, is 3.2 million years old. Other Australopithecus fossils, which are less known, are at least 3.9 million years old, but only jaws and teeth had been found. Without an old skull, our understanding of the evolution of these missing hominids remains very partial. Discovered in February 2016 at the Woranso Mile site in the Afar region of Ethiopia, some 55 kilometers from where Lucy was discovered, this new fossil would belong to one of the very first Australopithecus. Even if it is very small, the skull must have been that of an adult, apparently a male. Facial reconstructions based on the characteristics of the fossil shows a hominid with cheekbones projected forward, prominent jaws, a flat nose, and a narrow forehead. More details on the skull with Yassin Helselesi, an Ethiopian paleontologist who explains the characteristics.
We'll refer to this specimen as MRD, just for convenience purposes. It was discovered on February 10th, 2016, 3.5 years ago almost. And the place of discovery is Woranso Mile Study Area at a locality known as Mirodora in the Mile district of the Afar region of Ethiopia. And the geological age of the specimen is 3.8 million years.
The first is that MRD shows overlap between Annamensis and Afarensis in the Afar Triangle for about 100,000 years.
This latest discovery launches the dice, revealing that the two species crossed each other in the savanna of Afar for about 100 years. To the surprise of researchers, the skulls appears to be a mixture of characteristics specific to Sahelanthropus, such as Tomai and Ardipithecus and Ardi, but also to other more recent species. And according to researchers, until now, there has been a big gap between the oldest human ancestors, which are about 6 million years old, and species like Lucy's, which are 2 to 3 million years old. And for them, this discovery links the morphological space between these two groups. This Australopithecus skull discovered in Ethiopia is therefore a new piece of the puzzle of human evolution. All these elements put together make it possible to better understand the evolution of successive species in Australopithecus, and from when the branches separated to form the genus Homo, that is, the contemporary species of you and I. Questions and suggestions will continue on Twitter. See you next week. I'm Serge Kofi.